Hi, I'm Sheldon Rempel. I'm with the Vancouver Canucks organization, and I am on the I Only Touch Greatness podcast.
Looking for the most beers on tap, great steaks, great staff? Head over to the John B. Pub.
We got the best beers, steaks, chicken wings, nachos in town. Come see us at the John B. Pub.
The John B. Pub, the best bar in town. Come sign up for our football pool. Say hey, St. You.
Turn it up. The number one sports podcast in Vancouver with Ryan Hayes and Big Mike.
Ryan Hayes and Big Mike are taking over the podcast scene in Vancouver. Get down or lay down.
They need the points. Here's Skinner looking for the empty net. Rolling. He scores! Stuart Skinner! Unbelievable! Stuart Skinner has a goal! Oh my!
Oh wow.
And he's gonna do the flyby! Yes! This is unbelievable!
Born in Calgary. Tell us a little bit about childhood, and then tell us the transition to the BC Hockey League with the Clippers, and then on to Clarkson University.
Yeah, no, it was definitely, a different journey, I guess, kind of to the NHL, but longer, I guess, but no, it was awesome. I mean, I think kind of how it works in Calgary here is when you play midget, you can't leave the province until you're done your midget year. So I had a couple offers to go play in the Alberta League, and decided to wait it out and go and play in for the AAA team, and was lucky enough to have some opportunity with the BC teams, and then decided to go that route. And but obviously worked out pretty well for me, and right away kind of was talking to schools, and then committed to Clarkson. So that's kind of how it went down.
Okay. Right on.
We had a couple beauty ladies from Clarkston on, didn't we?
Yeah, a couple weeks back.
Did you play any other sports growing up? And what was there any that you excelled at?
Yeah, I mean, I think growing up, I kind of just picked up a new sport every summer. I never played summer hockey or anything like that. I kind of just, when the hockey season was done, I picked up a different sport. And nowadays I'm a big golfer, so kind of when the season ends is when I get my clubs out and I'm ready to rock. So I try to just play as much as I can, and that's just something I just love to do.
Right on.
I totally suck at golf. I love playing it and everything, but Jesus, I lose too many balls.
Jump right into for sure.
Yeah, I definitely lose a box of balls a round of golf, and not three box either. Like we're talking like the old 12 pack.
Yeah.
Any nicknames, and what's your favorite jersey number and why?
I think the standard Remps was my nickname growing up. I think that's kind of just the standard one, but for jersey numbers, I've had, a couple, I guess, throughout my years. I wore 11 for, I think, the majority of my years. I was lucky enough to get that in Nanaimo, and then as well as Clarkson. So I wore that a lot growing up, just for my brother. He wore that too. So I have had a couple more. I wore 23 in midget, and then when I turned pro, I kind of landed on 41, and then in the American League 27. That was kind of just what was given to me. So I don't mind it. I think it's a good little setup, I guess, but we'll see. I don't know what I haven't been asked yet from the organization, what I'm gonna wear there. So we'll see. Kind of maybe they'll just give me something.
Okay.
I know we're super pumped you're coming to Abbotsford, but you must be pumped as well.
Yeah, no, I'm looking forward to it for sure. So, hopefully, get down there in the next couple of weeks here and get skating down there, and I'm looking forward to it. So hopefully can, show well in camp and hopefully can crack the Canucks. But if not, then I'm gonna be excited to come to Abbotsford for sure.
Yeah, of course. Like the whole city's kind of buzzing about this. It's like having an expansion team it's pretty much an expansion team. I mean, it's a moved franchise, but it's pretty much coming here and then being, and at least it's not the Flames franchise this time. It's a Canuck one, and it's the whole city's buzzing about it. I'm pretty sure you guys will be sold out. If you end up in Abbotsford, it'll be sold out. And I mean, Canuck GM Place, so Rogers Arena will be sold out every night. But
yeah, no, absolutely. I mean, that's kind of what I've heard as well, is when the Flames organization was there, and I don't think they did great with fans just because it was Calgary's team. Obviously, yeah, they're more of a rival team, so I don't know why they would want to go and see Calgary's prospects. So no, I think it'll be a much better setup for sure. So I'm looking forward to it.
Awesome. And who do you meet your game after to try and play like?
That's a good question. I mean, I think there's, a couple, I guess, players that stick out to me. And, I think I would say, like a Mitch Marner or something like that. That's kind of where, I see myself playing like, or, maybe like a Travis Konecny or something like that. I haven't thought too much about it, but that's just kind of a, if I'm mm-hmm. doing an NHL comparison, then those two yeah. guys.
Good players, man.
So if you were having your dream dinner, and you can invite three, maybe four people, dead or alive, anyone famous, who would you want to invite?
Man, that's a good question for sure.
If you need an example, I always go with Tupac, Seth Rogen, Hulk Hogan, and then girls, I recently switched my pick to Blake Lively.
Okay, yeah, no, that's a good one for sure. I don't know, maybe I'd probably go something in the golf world, like a Brooks Koepka or something like that, or Tiger Woods. Obviously, that'd be, really cool. I'm just trying to think of, other athletes, maybe like a Tom Brady. Obviously, that's kind of a cliche, yeah. But, it would just be cool to sit down for a dinner with, some of the, world's top athletes. So I'm kind of drawing blanks right now, but
no, that's all good.
Sport by sport, I'd probably go, Brooks Koepka in golf and Tom Brady in football, and then maybe like a Roger Federer maybe in tennis. I'm just trying to figure out sports here, but
pretty much the
I think it'd be cool, yeah, for sure, to sit down with some of those people.
Pretty much the goat of each one.
Yeah,
exactly.
Do you have any pregame rituals or routines?
Not too many. I mean, you play a lot of games, so you kind of got to spice it up and do different stuff, each game. But obviously, you have more of a baseline of what you need to do, what you've done throughout your whole career. So I'm a big sewer ball guy, so I like playing soccer before the game, and that kind of gets the juices flowing a little bit, get competitive with the other guys. So that's for sure my number one.
And you must be happy to be coming back here where we got some Timmies.
Yeah, no, absolutely. I love Tim's for sure. I prefer it over Starbucks any day of the week, so it'll be good.
Would you go Tim Hortons over McDonald's?
I would, yeah. No, there's something about their coffee that just, I guess, it's different. So
it's addictive. How'd you lose the tooth?
Just a stick. Yeah, I just took a stick and, you know, half of it came off, and then I was hoping to get it capped, but the dentist said I had to pull it off, the full thing off. So so I'm rocking this look right now. My flipper doesn't fit too well, so kind of annoying to have it in once in a while. Yeah, I guess I could have thrown it in for the podcast here.
No, it's way better. What are you talking about? Way better.
Yeah.
After Clarkson, you obviously signed with LA. What was your first initial like instincts with signing with LA and getting your feet wet with the Kings?
Yeah, no, it was crazy. I mean, just such a long path for myself, and you know, to have you know a handful of teams offering NHL contracts, it was just, you know, a crazy situation for me. But yeah, I went for a visit down in LA, and you know, liked all the people down there, and you know, I thought that was the spot for me, so I ended up signing there. And then yeah, it was awesome. I mean, my first two years of pro, I'll remember forever. So you know, I made a lot of really good friends in that organization that I still talk to on a daily basis. So I have nothing but good things to say about the organization for sure.
Yeah, your rookie year in the A too, you lit it up. Taking back to your first AHL goal, if you remember it.
Yeah, no, it was, I think it was the second game of the season. I ended up getting off to a really good start my first year there. And my first goal was in Stockton. I kind of just came up the wall, and you know, the D kind of knifed through, and you know, it was a bigger body, so he kind of took up a lot of the traffic and kind of just threw it on net, and it just squeaked in. So yeah, it was really nice to get the first goal out of the way in a hurry, and I was able to build off that for sure.
Do you have a favorite sports movie?
Absolutely. I mean, there's a lot. I'm a big movie guy, so I don't know. Just off the top of my head, I'm just kind of going that golf route again. I like the Tin Cup movie for sure. I've watched that, you know, quite a few times.
Tin Cup, awesome.
Yeah, no, there's a lot of good ones. Like Coach Carter is obviously a good one.
Yeah,
remember the Titans, and you know, all those movies are awesome. I rewatch those all the time for sure.
Okay.
What would you say your favorite road barn was in the AHL?
I've played most, like obviously a lot of my games, you know, in that Pacific Division and in the California and Arizona, and there was Colorado in there as well. Actually, Colorado is a great, I think, AHL ring, just because it's kind of smaller and you know they sell that place out all the time. So. If I had to pick one, I'd probably say Colorado would be my favorite place to play on the road.
Okay.
For sure.
Okay. What about a dream venue? Do you have a dream venue that one day you wish to play in?
Like for a home rink or?
At all.
No.
It's like maybe, yeah, pretty much at all.
Are we talking about NHL or AHL? Or,
NHL.
Yeah. I mean, I've actually played in Rogers. I think that obviously I'm not being biased here, but that's obviously a really, really cool spot. You know, obviously, you know, my hometown is Calgary, so I always have a special place in my heart for the Saddle Dome. I know,
of course,
you know, a lot of guys talking to other guys, they don't love coming to play here just because it's such a older rink and pretty outdated, but no, I think it's just super cool. I think I love the setup, and you know, obviously the fans are crazy here as well. So yeah, we'll keep it local, and we'll go to Saddle Dome and Rogers.
There you go.
And you got in a couple of games in with Carolina last year as well. What was that like compared to playing in LA?
Yeah, no, it was different. Obviously, you know, it was at the start of the year, and there wasn't fans allowed in the building yet. So yeah, it was just completely different vibe, I guess, just because you know you just know how intense the NHL games are, and just to have it in front of no fans, it was different. But you know, obviously I was I was super excited to get that call and play in those games. And it was awesome for sure. It's different for sure than LA than the Staples Center. And PNC it's a little bit of an older rink as well, but it was awesome. You know, the coach there in Carolina, Rod Brendamore, he was awesome to me. And you know, he obviously I was pretty nervous going into those games because we hadn't played in over a year. So it was my first game back, and you know, I was kind of stepping right back into the fire in the NHL. So obviously I was pretty nervous, but he just calmed me down in the morning skate and stuff like that. So it was awesome for sure.
And I know there was no fans there, but the playing in Carolina, were you a fan of the storm surge?
Yeah, no, we didn't do it just because
there was no fans.
There was no fans, but I think it's good. I think it's good for the game. And, I think their fan base loves it.
Yeah.
And they thrive off of it. So, I mean, that's a big part of the sport is getting your fans behind you, and they obviously love it. So I have zero problem with that. I think it's pretty cool.
Yeah, because I'd say some people, like Don Cherry and incidents, like he wasn't too much of a fan of it. But and so I always, every time I get can think of a question with Carolina, that's the question I'm going to come up with. But
yeah, no, exactly. I think they're pretty known for that now. So I think it's good for sure.
Got any hidden talents?
I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. Tough questions today here, guys. I'm trying to think of some stuff off my head, but no, I mean, like I said before, just growing up, I just played, every sport you can think of just with my buddies and, making up random games and just stuff like that. So, I don't got anything for you there.
Okay. All right. If there was a karaoke contest with big prize money and you had to sing one song, what are you singing?
Right after he just gave a shit for giving him shitty questions.
a lot of teams do that as like a rookie thing. I don't know if you've ever had to do that, but a lot of teams I know do that for rookie initiation kind of thing.
Yeah, no, absolutely. That's actually a funny story for my rookie stuff. I kind of wrote a song when I was younger, not write a song, but made a song up that, I sang and kind of always got a kick out of the guys. So it was kind of just there's no name for it.
Custom. Yeah. I like it.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. So I just did that. Yeah, for sure.
What color's your stick tape and favorite Gatorade color?
I'm a black stick tape guy. I've always been. Yeah. No, I don't know why. I like it for some reason better. And, I just have that. I kind of take pride in that. I've never, I think a lot of guys, if they're on a slump or something like that, they change their tape color up, and I always give them grief just because, I kind of know what all the guys use, what color you kind of know, and I just give them grief that the other team's gonna know that you're slumping right now because you changed your color of your stick. So I take pride in my black stick tape, and I'm gonna stick with it for the rest of my career. And then
right on
for the Gatorade, probably like a light blue, maybe like a cool blue.
That's
my always go to for sure. So.
And how important is the stuff people post nowadays on social media and the player's image?
Yeah, no, it's huge. I mean, it can either go two ways. I think, it can be really good and really, you can do a lot of positive stuff with it, but you see sometimes guys get carried away and, then maybe they post too much. So, I try to post as much as I can, but, I try to stay away from it a little bit. Just I don't need kind of extra distractions. I just kind of want to, focus on myself. But, every once in a while, I'll get on there and pull some stuff for sure.
Okay. So back to Abbotsford. Do you know many of the guys on the team or with the Canucks?
Not too many. I actually knew, you know, a handful of guys that were with the organization last year, but unfortunately they're not coming back. But yeah, no, it'll be interesting. I don't know, you know, I obviously know of the guys, you know, I've played against a lot of them and stuff like that, but, you know, on a personal level, yeah, no, I don't know too many guys. So that's, you know, kind of why I'm looking to maybe get down there a little earlier and, you know, meet some of the guys and just to get comfortable and stuff like that. So it should be good.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Nice fresh start. It's good.
Yeah.
We'll be going to lots of games out there. It's about a half hour drive from us. So we will, right, we'll be making that trip. So we'll be seeing you out there and cheering you on. That's for sure.
Right on. Well, I appreciate
hopefully he's with the big boys though.
Yeah, true. Yeah, then I'll be seeing even more. I got Canuck season tickets.
Oh, there you go. There you go. Yeah, no, that's the hope. So we'll see, but no, it's going to be an awesome situation regardless. So I'm looking forward to it.
What's your personal highlight so far in your career?
Personal highlight. I don't know. I mean, I think, you know, just playing, you know, a game in the NHL has been, you know, up there for me, just to make it kind of all the way and to play that first game was obviously surreal and unbelievable. But, yeah, I mean, other than that, pro-wise, I think, you know, I was able to go to the, you know, AHL All-Star game my first year. I thought that was, you know, really cool for myself as well. And, yeah, just growing up, I guess in college, you know, just a lot of good memories and stuff like that. I remember, I think my last college goal was an OT winner to send us to the final in the ECAC championship. So just stuff like that, you know, you always remember and, you know, you'll just take that to the end of time, I guess.
Absolutely.
I got one, Mike. If you were an animal, what would you be?
Good question. I don't know, maybe a dog or something, just because I think people like them so much.
Yeah, man's best friend.
Hang out with your humans, I guess. But I don't know, maybe a bird or something. I think it'd be obviously really cool to fly. Other than that, I can't really think of any. Maybe a bird or a dog, I think, would be cool.
I always go with a dolphin because they got good personalities, and then they look like me. I got the big nose and no hair.
The big beak.
There you go.
That's right.
go to Selly. You got a go to? You have a go to Selly?
Oh,
one seeing a lot of
in junior and in college. I loved going on the one knee, but you know, kind of when I turned pro, I kind of had to shut that down. Maybe if it's a really big goal in the game, then maybe I'll pull that out, but. Yeah, maybe just a fist pump while I'm standing up. I always kind of throw something in there. So
I'm always at beer league going like John Cena, you can't see me.
There you go. Nice. Yeah.
So for the fans that haven't seen you yet, can you describe your game and playing style?
Yeah, no, I mean, obviously, you know, I think I'm, you know, a smaller player and, you know, I like to play fast. I like to play with skill and I try to be tenacious out there and, you know, hound pucks and stuff like that. And, but yeah, no, I think I'm a player that needs to make plays, to have success. And, you know, I love to score goals and obviously I haven't, have many goals, you know, this past year, I guess with a shortened season, but, yeah, no, definitely looking to take a step in my offensive abilities and go from there. So we'll see.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, we're excited to see that definitely out here. And I just want to thank you once again for taking the time for us today and coming on and chatting with us. Obviously we're big fans of you and we can't wait to see you in action.
Yeah. And come meet you.
Right on. Right on. Well, thanks for having me on, guys. I appreciate it.
For the most beers on tap, great steaks, great staff, head over to the John B. Pub.
We got the best beers, steaks, chicken wings, nachos in town. Come see us at the John B. Pub.
The John B. Pub, the best bar in town. Come sign up for our football pool. Say hey, St. You.